Hello. Today I will explain the different language sources that we have. Sometimes we don't know who's the creator of all the languages in the world. And these language sources are important to know as a future teacher, so I will explain each of them. The first source is the divine source. The divine source says that God gave to the human being the power of speech. When we talk about the divine source, we're not talking just about Christianism. We're talking about Catholicism and Hinduism. If we pay attention to all these religions, God gave to the humanity the power of speech in different ways. The divine source says that Hebrew was the first language in the world. Hebrew was spoken by Adam in the Garden of Eden. Also, there was an experiment with children. These children were put in isolation without any contact human. And these children weren't able to speak. Why? Because they didn't have the interaction with other people. So that's why the divine source has a lot of doubts around it. And the second one is the natural sound source. This one says, before birth, our auditory system is already functioning. The Babel theory, it says that we, as humans, we try to imitate some sounds. But we don't imitate very well, so we create another sound, and that sound we use it to refer to some objects that we don't have in that moment. Some examples could be cow cow or coco. It sounds something like the baby do. When they want something, they don't name the object for its name. They use some sounds to refer to that object that they want. The next theory is the poo-poo theory. Yeah, that name. Yes, the poo-poo theory. The poo-poo theory says that we imitate sounds of the emotional circumstances, such as when we are happy, angry, when we feel sad. We can imitate the sound of those situations. And the third source is the social interaction source. In this source, it says that we develop our skills of speech when we are in large groups, when we are with many people, because it is important to communicate, and it's very important to have some interaction with another people. So here it says that it's very important for us as human beings. And of course, it helps us to produce some sounds. Some, maybe we can talk about pronunciation. Sometimes there are many words that we don't know, but some people can't pronounce them well. So in the social interaction, we can talk about this situation. And the fourth one is the physical adaptation source. In this source, we have three characteristics. The first one is teeth and lips. The second one is mouth and tongue. And the third one is larynx and pharynx. Yes. And the first characteristic that we have is teeth and lips. And what it says about it, it says that teeth and lips are very important. They're not useful just for eating. They are useful because they help us to produce some sounds, such as and we can say that or So it's very important to know about it. The next characteristic is mouth and tongue. And what it says about it, it says that it are very important because as human beings, we can open and close it rapidly. Some animals cannot do. Yeah, we are animals. So we can do it, and it's an advantage for us because it helps us to produce sounds more rapidly, and it helps us to speak easily. And the third one, we have the larynx and pharynx. Those are very important because in larynx we have our vocal cords that help us to produce some sounds, many sounds. And the fifth sort is the tool-making sort. The tool-making sort, it is that we use our hands or gestures to communicate. Of course, if we are talking about human gestures as communication, our human brains are involved in this because our motor movements are required for speaking. As we have already seen, there are different sources that we must know, because if we pay attention to these sources, we are going to know where the languages come from. In conclusion, all the sources are related because every single source, it helps us to know why we speak the way we speak. Personally, I think that all the sources are important, but because I believe in God, I'm still believing in the divine source. All the sources are useful, but my belief is in the divine source, especially if we talk about Christianism. So this was my video. Thank you for your attention.